of Boss Babes and Bosses out there. So in this video, as I promised to you, I will be sharing the tools that can help you generate content for your social media accounts, maybe for your YouTube channel, or if you have a podcast, if you have a website and you want to generate content for your blog, something like that. Or maybe if you're a freelancer and you are helping your client to generate content for their platforms as well, then this video is for you. First thing na masasuggest ko talaga, the very, very, very best way to know or generate a content idea para sa social media accounts mo or ayun sa blog or vlog or podcast is to ask your audience. Maybe may ginawa ka ng Facebook group and you can ask from there. Or maybe you can just ask sa Instagram mo. If you have an Instagram, this is what I do. I have my Facebook group here. I'm asking those boss babes and bosses na nasa loob kung ano yung mga content ideas na nag-expect sila na gagawa ko ng content. And then also, sometimes I also post in my Instagram account and I'm asking there if they want to see this kind of content, yung mga ganun. But the problem now is that if wala ka pang na-build na audience, yung kakasimula mo lang pa talaga. So the 6 ways and tools that I'm going to share with you would be really helpful to generate content ideas na for sure meron talagang titingin or babasa or maglilisan. Yeah, those kind of contents. The first tip that I'm going to share with you is through your YouTube channel. Why? Because YouTube channel is a very, very good source of the most searched content. Makikita mo yan sa mga the same na niche mo. So I will share my screen so that you can see how you can do it. Okay, so you are seeing my screen now. And as you can see, I'm on my YouTube dashboard. So, it's okay if wala kayong YouTube channel, as long as you can still search here sa YouTube. And then, I would like you to download VidIQ, Vision for YouTube, so that we can see a lot of numbers and keywords na pwede nyo magamit in creating your content or, you know, in searching for content sa mga social media accounts nyo or maybe sa blog or vlog or podcast niyo. Okay, so let's go back here. As long as you have installed this one app, na-install ko na kasi siya, so remove yung nakalagay sa akin dito. But if kayo hindi niyo pa to na-install, you can just click the install button here and then that's it. After that, you should go back here and then search for the niche that you are in. So kung ano yung niche mo, so let's say SEO. SEO yung niche mo or yung search engine optimization. Okay, so here, as you can see, meron tayong nakikitang panel dito. This is because of the extension that you have installed sa browser mo. Then don't forget to turn this on para makita mo yung mga keywords na ginagamit nila. Ito yung kadalasan na ginagamit ng mga YouTubers na nilalagay nila sa videos nila. Mga tags, mga keywords, yon. So dito makikita mo rin na ang word na SEO mataas yung views and then yung volume din is good. So, ang overall score is high. And the competition is medium perfect. So, ito yung reason why I want you to download this one para makita nyo yung top channels. Meaning, maraming nagsasubscribe dito. Meaning, marami silang content about SEO na nag-viral or something ganun. So, I want you to open the 3 top channels. And dito na yung sinasabi ko na pupunta kayo sa YouTube channel and then click here sa video and then don't forget to click the most popular. The reason why you want to click the most popular, meaning maraming gustong matuto niyan na topic. So yan yung goal natin, to create a topic na maraming gustong makinig or mag-watch or magbasa. So ito yung mostly about SEO na maraming nagbabasa. You can get an idea from their content as well, but if you will get an idea, don't forget to give them credits And also, wag niyo lahat kopyahin. Have your own version then sa content niyo. Like, your own thoughts, your own examples, your own strategy, your own tips. And if you will get even just a little idea about that video, don't forget to give credit to that content creator. So, ito, pwede niyo itong mailist na baka pwede niyong magawa ng own version niya ng content. And then, dito rin, the same. Go here, videos again. And don't forget to click most popular. And ito dito, kunin niyo lang yung mga SEO na maraming views. That's the main point. So, the same here. And then, sa third channel. And then, that's it. So, the second tip that I'm going to share with you on how to source content is through your Facebook account. So, if you still haven't joined any Facebook group na ka-niche nyo or ka-niche ng client nyo, I want you to join those kind of groups. And then from there, you can see or you can easily see what content topic or what content ideas you can post. So right now, I want you to go to your Facebook and then join the Facebook groups kung saan nang doon nag-hangout yung mga target clients mo or yung mga ideal customers mo. So for example, a lot of my friends, yung mga target clients nila are mga female entrepreneurs. So, I will get that as a sample. For example, let's say, okay, so I'm part of this. Yan yung group na kadalasan dyan is yung mga target clients mo, and then join that. Please answer the pre-membership questions because a lot of them would not accept you if you will not answer all the questions, same as mine. So here, I want you to go down. May mga posts sila and then may mga comments dito. Marami ka ding mababasa kung ano yung mga things na gusto nilang malaman, gusto nilang matutunan. And so, you can drop value bombs to the comment box. You can answer their questions if alam mo yung sagot. And then here, if wala kayong time to do that, to always scroll, I want you to go here, this popular topics in this group. So, see all. Punta kayo dito sa mga ask or help. Go to this kind of topic kasi more likely they need help. So, let's say yung ito lang may ask. Ito. If you know how to answer this, you can drop a comment here. Our goal here is to make them aware that you exist, that you can help them sa business nila. Yeah, parang para makuha mo lang yung attention nila. Or you can just really create a content based from their questions. So, ito. Ask ito. This is for just market research. Ito din. Ito yung mga mostly tayong mga freelancers alam kung paano or paano sila matulungan sa mga tanong na yan. Why our technique is like this, because the more that we know someone asked it, the more there is a big chance na marami din the same yung questions na ganyan. Marami din sigurong nalilito niyan, marami din sigurong hindi alam yan, tapos you know how to answer it, you know the answer, then you can create a content from it. Here, sa topics, there's also a menu here at the top. You can click that one and just search for the keywords like ask, questions, help, advice, or something like that. Ito yung mga ginagamit nila ng mga keywords or tags kung may itatanong sila. The more na may nag-ask tapos sasagutan mo, more likely talaga makukuha mo agad yung attention nila and more likely din marami din gustong babasa sa content mo. So the third tip that I'm going to share with you on how to source content topics or content ideas is to use a plugin. It's called Keyword Research. So you can install that one to your browser. Actually, I've heard this tip kay Vanessa Lau na video, but before niya to na-publish na video or na-mention is I already used this one sa isang client ko. That's, I guess, 2016? Ang work ko kasi nun is to help my client optimize yung website niya for SEO ranking. So I'm using keyword research to see ano yung mga keywords na mas marami yung nagsa-search. So I will share my screen again para makita niyo kung paano siya gamitin at kung paano mo malaman kung ano pa yung other content topics or ideas na pwede mong ma-share sa accounts mo. Just install it, click the install button here, but as for me, I've already installed it, kaya remove from Chrome siya. So you can just Google it, like something like that, and then click mo lang tong Chrome, Google, and then install niyo siya. So that's how easy it is. So now if na-install mo na siya, just go back to Google, and then here, let's type, since SEO na yung mga previous sample natin, click mo lang yung Google search SEO, and then meron kang makikitang parang panel dito sa gilid, and ito yung in-install mo na keywords everywhere. Makikita mo kung ano yung trend niya from 2014. Ngayon, ang dami nang nagre-research about SEO. So, we have 598 million results in just 45 seconds. That's a very big volume. And then, makikita mo dito yung mga related keywords. And then, from here, you can get this keyword. Ito yung mostly maraming nagre-research. So, what is SEO and how it works? SEO meaning. So, these are the topics that you can create kasi for sure maraming nagkaka-interest niyan kasi always siyang nire-research sa Google. You can also use this one, like you can create a topic about types of SEO. Top 10 SEO companies. Google SEO tools. So, ayun. What is successful SEO? You can create content, specific content na makikita mo dito sa people, also search for na section, and then dito din sa related keywords. So, yeah, that's that for the keywords. I love using this one as well because nagsasuggest talaga siya ng specific content topics. So the next tip that I'm going to share with you is to use Quora in generating content topics or content ideas. So I also haven't used Quora before, but because of Vanessa Lau again, nalaman ko siya kung paano gamitin and kung paano siya ma-maximize to generate content ideas.
So for Quora, if you are not yet signed in or if you don't have any account yet, you can sign up using your Gmail account. But as for me, I already have an account and naka-sign in na ako. So I will just go through na directly kung paano maghanap ng content na pwede nyong ilagay sa social media nyo, sa blogs nyo, or sa vlogs or podcast. So here, meron akong mga discovered spaces. Ito yung mga content na lalabas dito sa newsfeed ko. Kung sa Facebook pa, newsfeed. So, yeah, ito yung mga content na gusto ko na nandito sa feed. But, for us, I would like you to search the niche that you want to research na gagawa nyo ng content. For example, your niche is about Labrador dogs, then you can search Labrador dogs. But, based sa mga naging previous sample natin, SEO, so panindigan ko na, SEO na yung gawin natin na example lahat. So, dito sa all types, just click ako, pumupunta ako sa mga questions because I love to answer questions. For me kasi, yung dating na questions, kung merong nag-a-ask, meron ding ibang nag-a-ask niyan. Hindi lang isa ang nag-a-ask. So, ito yung mostly na tinatanong about SEO. So, I can pick topics here na sa tingin ko kaya kong sagutan. I can have my own answer. So, that's that. Pwede din kayong pumunta dito sa answers if gusto niyo talaga ng answer about SEO. Tapos, what are the top techniques for SEO? Tapos, meron din siyang mga answers na. Start listening to these two podcasts, Digital Marketing and Online Marketing Tips. Itong mga ganito. And then, ayun, mga ibang questions din na meron na ding mga answers. You can view all the answers. Merong view all na button. And then, ayun, the more na mas maraming mag-up, the more na legit or the more na nag-a-agree na yan yung answer. So, kung merong mag-thumbs down naman, ito yung comment as well. Meron kang makikitang comments kung may mag-comment sa answer, di ba? Ito yung mga answers sa tanong na ito. So, you can also browse that one to have an idea. Balik tayo dito, pwede ka din pumunta sa post. You can also see here ano yung mga usually na mga post about SEO. You can also have an idea from here. Again, as what I have said earlier, that if you will get content idea from other creators, don't forget to give credits. And then, profiles. Ito yung mga profiles na yung topic nila is about SEO as well. So, ayan, makikita mo yung mga profiles. And then, of course, topics then. And, yeah, I think that's that. That's that for Quora. What's good here is that you can have a very, very specific content as well. Kung nalilito ka kung ano talaga yung content topic, then you can go here sa questions or answer or posts para makita mo kung ano yung mas magandang sagutan na question.
So the fifth tip that I'm going to share with you is a website, answerthepublic.com. Vanessa Law also mentioned this one, but I already knew this one before pa niya na-mention kasi my client already taught me on how to use it. Naka-Facebook live siya every Thursday night, EST. Nalilito talaga ako when it comes to ano. Time zone. Ako naman. Okay, so, basta, ayun, isa sa mga responsibility ko is to help him generate content topics na i-discuss niya sa live niya and nilalagay ko lang siya sa Excel and then sa Excel din doon ko din nilalagay yung mga points na kailangan niyang ma-mention sa live niya, yung mga gano'n, something gano'n. Basta siya yung nagturo talaga sa akin on how to use answerthepublic.com. I'm not using it for myself though, but I'm using it for my clients, so maybe this would be also really helpful for you.
Just research Answer the Public on Google and go to their website, answerthepublic.com, or you can just type it in sa browser nyo, answerthepublic.com, and here you can put the keyword, like for example, SEO. So, naging example natin SEO. So, here, merong ito mga topics to siya na pwede mong gawin. Ang topics, SEO how, SEO why, SEO who, where, which, blah, blah, blah. Click mo lang yung data. So, ito yung R, can, how. So, are SEO services worth it? You can also create a content for that. Are SEO and SEM the same thing? How SEO works step by step? What SEO stands for? Yung mga ganun. So, it's easier for you. Ito naman yung mga preposition like... Huwag natin siya yan, i-data. Mas gusto ko siyang naka-data para hindi bumabaliktad yung mundo ko. So, SEO for beginners, SEO for website, SEO for YouTube. So, you can have a lot of good content topics as well. Ito yung mga questions then na mostly yung, ito yung mga questions from the public na gusto nila ng answer. So, that's why the domain is Answer the Public. .com. So, yeah, that's how simple it is.
So, the next tip that I'm going to share with you is to use your social media accounts. Like, I would highly recommend to get inspiration or content topics sa Pinterest or sa Instagram or sa Facebook. Like, i-save niyo lang siya. Like, for example, ako, I don't really intentionally search for ano kayang content topic na gawin ko ngayon. More likely, nagbabrowse-browse lang ako sa Instagram. Tapos, hey, maganda to na content ah. So, isi-save ko na lang siya. So, I'm just saving it talaga. I have a folder for that sa Instagram ko. I also have another folder. Sa Facebook ko, sometimes nag-browse ako. And then, meron din akong gustong isave. Actually, pwede na siyang i-public or i-private. So, me, I'm just putting it private. Kasi that is just for myself. For the content creation that I would like to create. And then also sa Pinterest, then that's a good platform to gather content topics na pwede niyong ma-share sa mga social media accounts niyo. Like, I have a board na for content topics na pwede ko din ma-share. And then, naka-private lang din siya. So, I will share again my screen so that I can teach you how to do it.
Okay, for you to save content here naman sa Facebook, feeling ko sa inyo mostly alam na on how to do this. But I would like to still give a quick tutorial since maybe some of you don't know how to do it. Like, for example lang ha, this content, I want to save it kasi gusto kong gumawa din ng content na the same na ganito. I will just hit the three dots here at the top and then save post. And then, since I don't have any collection yet, I will just click new collection. And then, lagyan ko ng for content creation. And then, when you are going to click view item, nakalagay dito na only me. So, therefore, ako lang makakakita nito. And hindi siya makikita ng iba. Only me nga, no? So, ayan. That's just how easy it is. And I will teach again para na naman sa Instagram. So, here naman sa Instagram, just the same lang din. Pero hindi na sa three dots at the top. Dito na sa parang may ribbon. For example, I want to save this content from KTune. And then, click ko lang tong button na parang ribbon sa baba. And then, since I don't have any saved folders here, we can create, for example, for content creation. Then you can be specific as much as you like for SEO or for motivation folder or for social media content ideas, yung mga ganun. But kung gusto niyo na parang general lang talaga, na hindi talaga super specific, you can just do the same title, like for this one, and then just hit save. And then for another, like for this one. This is just a sample again, na hindi talaga to mga super totoong content na isi-save na for content purposes. And then here, for content na naman. And then like, here, you have to hold it. Hindi lang siya click, one click. Kasi pag ganun, hindi siya papasok sa collection. So, you have to long press it and then for content. Pwede naman na i-click mo lang siya. Tapos, click niyo itong save to collection. Tapos, lalabas tong for content. So, ayan. That's just how easy it is. So, yeah. Okay, so here in Pinterest, if you don't have any account yet here, sa Pinterest, you can sign up using your Gmail account or your Facebook account. And as for me, I already signed up and I'm already signed in na. So, andito ako sa homepage ko. So, probably you have an account na rin if you are following my tutorials because naging part itong Pinterest sa isa kong tutorial. So, ayun. Now, para makagawa tayo ng board of content na gusto natin gawan in the future, just click the magnifying icon here sa gilid and then search nyo. For example, SEO na naman. Here, for example, click lang natin siya sa save. But then, wala pa akong board for SEO. Create board. And then, lagyan natin SEO contents. I like it to be private. Like, ilagay ko lang siya as secret. Kasi, this is just for me na magkaroon ako ng idea kung ano yung mga content na gusto ko when it comes to SEO. So, therefore, walang makakakita na iba nito. And then, I will just hit create. So, meron na tayong isang pin na nakasave sa SEO. So, ito yung SEO audit checklist. So, click mo lang to. Save. So, dalawa na. SEO writing. Oh, maganda to. Kasi for beginner's guide. Click naman siya ulit. And then, save. So, that's how easy it is. So, just go back sa profile mo. Dito ka sa save. Here is the SEO content board. So, if you are going to click that one, ito na yung mga na-save mo. And then, pwede dang more ideas about SEO pa rin and SEO for YouTube, SEO for Pinterest, for example, let's say But the powerful website factors optimize your SEO, like you just have to save it. And then when you go back sa board mo, andun na siya. Ito. Ito siya, right? So that's how easy you can do it. You can also organize this if you want. And yeah, that's it.
So yeah, that's that. That's the 6 ways or tools that you can use to generate content topics for your social media accounts, website, blog, or podcast, or YouTube channel. So the main thing here is that if you are getting content inspiration from other creators, please, please don't copy everything. Have your own version of it. Make a twist. Share something that is different. And make it a better content. Make the content yours. Na though meron kang kinuhang idea, but make sure na meron ka ding sayo din. Always remember that your aim is to create a content that is very engaging, that can help your clients or your customers build trust to you so that it will be easier for you to convert a sale or to get leads from your content. So yeah, always make sure that yung content niya is naka-based sa buyer's journey stages, which is the awareness stage, consideration stage, and conversion stage. So if you haven't watch my previous video na nag-explain ako niyan, watch this video here para hindi kayo maguluhan. Hopefully, nakahelp to sa inyo kahit konti. And if so, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button para ma-notify kayo every time mag-upload ako ng content. So before I'm going to end this video, I would like to flex the works of my boss babes and bosses inside my group. Check this out! If you would like to join our Facebook page, just research I'm Ready to Boss Up by Brooke Sui. And don't forget to like our page, Boss Up PH. And also don't forget to follow our Instagram account, Brooke Sui and Boss Up PH. So yeah, hope to see you guys at my next one. Bye!